That was the big jam of 2015.
It was.
Hi friends! Welcome back to our channel if you've seen our videos before. And if you are new, my name is Abby.
My name is Hope.
And we're
the Disney Sisters. In today's video, we are doing a tag that has been going around for the past month. Mm-hmm. And we are very behind the... what is it called?
Behind
the trend? The curve?
Behind the...
times? We're very behind the curve with filming this video. We have been tagged by some wonderful people to do this video, so we are excited to be filming it today. So the people who have tagged us are Vicky from Vixen Lost in Disney,
Robin from Oh Hello Robin,
and Beth from the Collectioneers Club.
We'll link all of their channels in the description. Go check them out. They're all really great people.
Yeah. So, to be honest, we've been trying to get this video together for weeks. But it's hard to figure out a time that we could both get our pins and sit down and just talk about pins with you guys.
Yeah.
So, that's what we're gonna do today.
Let's do it.
And I am so ready.
I'm so pumped.
Let's go. Oh, we didn't even explain what we're doing.
Wow.
Today, we are participating in the 19 for 2019 pin tag.
This tag was created by Nina from Wrestling with Disney and Alicia from Cinder Alley Loves Disney, and we will link both of their channels in the description as well.
And there are 19 questions that kind of take you through the calendar year a little bit, which is kind of fun. Question one is, Happy New Year! Share a pin with a year noted on it.
My pin for this question is this 2014 Visa Cards from Chase Disney pin. It was a Visa
That's
Chase
cool.
exclusive that my parents gave me for my birthday that year. It's got Kermit on it, and the balloon is like raised, rubberized material, and it's so cute. And I love it. I think it's supposed to look like maybe Hollywood Studio Streets of America kind of a look to it,
yeah.
And I really like it a lot. Particularly because the Streets of America are no more.
My pin for this question, I wasn't sure which way we were supposed to go, if it was supposed to be a pin with this current year on it, with 2019, or just any year. So for my 2019 pin, the only pin I have that actually has the year 2019 on it, so far, is the Happy New Year pin with Cinderella and Prince Charming. And it's like the clock tower face, and it says Walt Disney World, Happy New Year, and then 2019. So that's like an honorable mention, but I've shown that to you guys a few times now. So, because I've shown that pin to you a few times recently, I thought I would pick a different pin for this question. So, the pin I'm going with is this Lady and the Tramp 1955 pin. And that was the year that this movie came out. This pin is one of the Countdown to the Millennium series pins, and this is number 73 of 101. So, it just has Lady and Tramp, and they are eating the spaghetti together, and it's very cute, and it has the year right there at the bottom.
I would have picked a 2019 pin, but I don't have any yet, so...
Yeah,
I was like, 2014
in the year to have 2019.
That's true.
So,
well, I mean, we could have gotten the mystery boxes, but we haven't done that yet. So. Question two is, how long have you been pin collecting? We started in 2011.
It was the fall of 2011.
Yeah.
And then I did not start trading pins until 2012. But
we started collecting pins in 2011.
Yeah.
We just bought the ones we liked.
Yeah, it's been a while.
It's been a little while.
I didn't realize it had been so long.
Yeah.
Wow. question three. Briefly share how you got started in pin collecting and what you like about it.
I think I just bought them because you were wanting to start.
Okay, story time. So,
here comes the
in
tea.
2011, I wanted to start pin collecting, and our family in general kind of got into it, and we were researching how to do it, pin trading worked in the parks, and we thought, oh, that would be a fun, like, family activity that we can do in the parks. So...
I don't think I was privy to those conversations.
You weren't. Both of our birthdays are in the fall, and so my parents had said, okay, when your birthday comes in October, we'll buy you a pin lanyard and pins, and you can start this going. So I'm like, cool, and this was, like, maybe summer when we were starting to talk about this. So I'm like waiting patiently for my pin lanyard to come. Anticipating. I'm like planning out what theme I want to go with.
She like picked out a lanyard.
Yeah. So I'm like preparing all this stuff. And then in September, which is Abby's birthday, our parents took her to Disney for her birthday. Like a solo trip.
It was fun.
Kind of thing. And she comes back with a lanyard with a medal with
three.
Tons.
I didn't have tons. I had three.
It was more than three.
I bought three. I maybe traded a couple, but I bought three. So.
It was a lanyard with pins. And I was like, what? What? Yeah. Little Hope wasn't happy. But it was okay because then, like, 3 weeks after that when my birthday came, I got it. But.
And I only Ooh. Had those three pins for solid, yeah, almost a
I
year.
I mean, if you were to say, like, which one of us
is the pin is collector, it's her.
Yeah.
Although my pin collection is way bigger than I thought it was. I was going through for this tag,
it's
and I was like,
I thought it was too. I was like,
whoa.
Girlfriend. That's the story.
That's
I'm not
the story. That's the tea, folks. Question four. Share your newest pin. Okay, guys. Okay, this is my newest pin, and
that's a big one.
Oh, it's so beautiful. This is from 2016, so it's this ginormous pin that says Starlight Safari, Disney's Animal Kingdom Lodge.
My pin for this answer is one of my new favorite pins. I debated whether or not to show it as my newest pin or my favorite pin because it's up there. But it is this 2000 Cinderella and Prince Charming pin, and it is them on their wedding day, and Prince Charming is giving Cinderella a kiss on her hand, and it just says, 2000 Walt Disney World, celebrate the future hand in hand. And this one is, like, all of my favorite things in one pin. It is older, it's from the year 2000. It is Cinderella and Prince Charming, which are my favorite, Cinderella's one of my favorite princesses, and it's just beautiful. This one is a limited edition of 2000. That makes sense. So, it says right there in case you forget. So, this is my newest pin and one of my new favorites. So, this was a fun one to kind of find pins for because I was just going through counting characters on pins.
I actually have a couple coming later in this tag that could have applied for this, but
yeah, I actually had a few pins that kind of can work for other categories, which is kind of fun.
Yeah.
So the pin that I chose for this one is my Tsum Tsum stack pin, and this one is Mickey as the medium or large size Tsum Tsum. It has a bunch of characters on him. So it's Chip, Dale, Donald, Daisy, Minnie, Marie, and Pluto.
That's a lot of characters.
This one has 8 characters on it, and I think that was the most I could find. So,
yeah.
This one is from 2014, and it's just an open edition pin, but it works wonderfully in my Tsum Tsum collection.
So the one that I chose for this question is this Disney's Art of Animation Resort pin.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, I got this back when we stayed at AOA, as the cool kids say.
No. We're not cool.
I got this back when we stayed at Art of Animation, and so it has Ariel, Mufasa and Simba, Dory, and I guess that's Nemo, and
yeah.
Lightning McQueen, and a couple of those little seahorse guys from Little Mermaid. So this has 6 or 9, depending on if you count the seahorses, characters on it, and I thought it worked really well for this question. Question 6. Your Disney pin that features the most obscure film or character. So I actually have 2 answers for this question. I know, I'm cheating, but I had 2. Partially because I've already shown you this one. So this is a Happy Holidays 2016 Disney's Coronado Springs Resort pin, and it has Burrito, which is the Three Caballeros flying donkey. Fun fact, I haven't even seen Three Caballeros, but I still got this pin because I really loved it, and it's so pretty. And this one is limited edition of 750. Which might be my lowest edition size out of all of my pin collection now that I'm thinking about it.
Oh, maybe.
Maybe. maybe not, I don't know. And the other one that I picked is this Hidden Mickey Rufus pin from Kim Possible, which might be less obscure now because Disney Channel's live action remake is coming this summer. But yeah, this pin is just adorable. Look at him. He's so excited. He's gonna be like, he's got his fighting stance. Yeah, so those are my two answers for this question.
My answer for this question is this pin, and Donald is not the character that I'm talking about today, but it is actually this little guy, and this is the Little Green Man of Disneyland. This pin was actually a limited edition of 4,000 from 2017, but the Little Green Man of Disneyland is actually from a Disney Golden Book from 1955. So this little man has been around as long as Disneyland has. And in Disneyland, in one of the trees, if you look at the roots of the tree, you can actually see his little house. And
well, we have to find that when we go.
I know. And where the little green man lives.
That's so cool.
And so he's just a little leprechaun man. And he is my most obscure character.
He's pretty obscure, I would say.
And I love him. He is a little leprechaun, like I said, but he literally lives in Disney, so I'm like, hey, can I come visit you? Like,
I would totally come live
in Disney. Yeah. Question 7. Share a pin that represents your Valentine for 2019, or who you hope will be your Valentine. So, for me, I actually, surprisingly, don't have that many Valentine's pins. I have quite a few St. Patrick's Day pins, because that is one of my collections. But I don't have that many Valentine pins. But I decided to go with this one, aww, because I love their expressions on this one. So Mickey is holding a bouquet of flowers for Minnie behind his back, and he's going to surprise her with it. And she's like, what is it? Are you going to show me? What is it? And they're standing in a little heart. And this one is a pin from 2005, and it was an open edition pin. And I love all the red, too.
Yeah. Because
a lot of times they mix the pink and the red, and this one has red, which is kind of nice.
My Valentine's Day pin is also red. Look at that. If I was going to spend Valentine's Day with any Disney character, I would probably pick a Disney dog. The dog that I chose is Doug from Up. Because that would just be a fun day.
That would be hilarious.
That would be so funny and so wonderful, and I would absolutely enjoy it. So this is just a Hidden Mickey pin, 5 of 5. It was a collection, I think, of Disney dogs, if I'm not mistaken. Or Disney sidekicks.
It was Disney-like characters.
Yeah. Question 8. It's not easy being green, even if it's St. Patrick's Day. Share a green pin. So, I'm gonna go first, because obviously Hope's gonna blow me out of the water on any St. Patrick's Day related.
Oh, that's not true. Behold this pin that Abby's about to share. It's amazing.
Okay, so this is a WDI Imagineer exclusive limited edition of 300, so this is my lowest size, I forgot about this one, St. Patrick's Day Figment pin. I love this.
That's a big pin,
so much. Okay, so it has him sitting on a pot of gold in his little leprechaun outfit with a sparkly shamrock, and oh, I love it so much. It's so perfect. I love this pin. It's so pretty, and it's so cute, and I love it.
I like that one too, and I think I like the combination of the green and purple.
Yeah,
it's not a normal,
a nice contrast.
Yeah, I like it. My pin for this answer is one of my newer additions to my St. Patrick's Day collection, and this one is Mickey and Minnie from the Cruise Line. This one says, Happy St. Patrick's Day 2007, and it's Disney Cruise Line, and so it's cute. Mickey and Minnie, and Minnie is giving Mickey a big smooch, but they're both glittery, and it says Disney Cruise Line official pin trading 2007, and it's a limited edition of 500.
So cute.
And it's a pin-on-pin, too, which is nice because it's heftier.
Yeah.
But yeah, that is one of my new favorites for St. Patrick's Day.
And it's very green.
It's, so it's very,
very
green.
Perfect for this question.
This one answers the
question. There's a lot of green.
Very well. Number 9, share your number one favorite pin. Now,
this is a hard question.
This question is a little unfair because, to be honest, my favorite pin changes daily.
Mine too.
Like, at least weekly. because I will have one pin and say, yeah, that's my favorite pin, and then I will rediscover a love for another pin that I'm like, oh, this is my favorite. Yeah. So, today, my favorite
today,
pin.
Today, these are our favorite pins.
So, this is my current favorite pin, and this one is from the Epcot Candlelight Processional in 2016.
That's a good one.
And it was an annual pass holder pin, and it's a very ornate ornament, and when you open it, it has Lady and Tramp, and they are looking at each other, they're under the mistletoe, and it actually is, you can use it as an ornament and hang it up, or you can use it with the pin posts, but it is a limited edition of 2000, and it says Epcot Holiday Around the World on the back. So, this one, I just love how gold it is.
It's so pretty.
It's so ornate and beautiful, and then I love Lady and Tramp's expression on the inside. They are just looking at each other so lovingly.
Yeah.
So, yeah, this is my current favorite pin.
Some of you are probably going to laugh at this answer because it's not nearly as, like, ornate as yours.
Whoa.
But this pin just brings me so much joy.
I love this one.
Festival of the Arts is my favorite festival. You guys know this already. Probably. It's been running for 3 years now. The hunt that they do is Figment's Brush with the Masters, which essentially takes famous paintings and puts Figment in them and puts them up around the world showcase. And they're so great. So last year, they made pins of those paintings, and I have a couple of them, but this one's my favorite because Washington Crossing the Delaware is one of my favorite, like, classic paintings, and Figment's at the bottom of the boat, and I love it, and I love the frame. It's so pretty, and yeah, it's, like, got an artist palette at the top and Figment's head down at the bottom, which is the way that you can identify the paintings in the hunt. If you see a Figment frame, then you know you found the right one, and it's got this little dangling Festival of the Arts element down here, and this one is a limited edition of 2500 from 2018 Epcot International Festival of the Arts, and I love it so much. It just makes me happy when I look at it.
Yeah. It's interesting that we both chose, like, gold ornate pins.
Yeah, that's true.
But,
yeah.
I love that
one. The back of this one's really cool, too.
It's like a matte finish.
I like this one a lot. Question 10. April showers bring May flowers. Share a pin that shows off nature. So, nature. It's another Epcot festival pin. Who's surprised?
Not me.
This is genuinely another one of my favorite pins. I just adore this pin. So this was also from last year, the Flower and Garden Festival, and this is the pass holder exclusive for 25 years of the festival, and this one is limited edition of 3,000 as well. And it's just got Figment up here, and he's rubberized, which is kind of cool, and he is, like, trimming up this bush that says pass holder. He's making it look very nice, and there's so many flowers and plants. There's carrots and, like, radishes. There's a snail. I didn't even see the snail before. There's cabbages, and it says 25 years. Epcot International Flower and Garden Festival is what it says on this dangly bit, and I...
That's a really good...
This was too perfect pin for nature. I could not use it, so I love this pin too.
So, my pin for this answer kind of could belong in Abby's pin, I chose this adorable little Mickey ladybug. I was gonna say Hidden Mickey. It's not a Hidden Mickey pin, but it has
Hidden Mickey
in it. And this one was from the Flower and Garden Festival 2018 as well. This one came in a 4-pin set, which I think I've shown some of the other pins in this set on the channel already, but I don't know that I've ever shown the ladybug. And so this one is limited edition of 1500. But, fun fact, ladybugs are my favorite insect, and really the only insect that I truly like.
I didn't know that about you.
No.
Well, I probably could have guessed it if
I
thought
about it. Yeah, I was gonna say, like...
I've never really heard you say the ladybug is my favorite insect.
Well, I don't really choose favorite insects very often, but the ladybug is my favorite. I love ladybugs, and they're very cute. So, this one is my pin for this answer. Question 11. What pin represents summertime to you? So, I actually have two pins for this answer, but they kind of go together. So, these are both Hidden Mickey pins, but from different years. So this one is my main pin for this answer, and it is a Hidemiki watermelon. So this was a completer pin from a Hidemiki set in 2009, and it's the whole watermelon, and it's in the shape of a Mickey head. The second pin that I'm going to be sharing along with that one is this newer Hidemiki watermelon pin, and this one, I love that they made the seeds into little Mickey heads.
That's so cute.
So this one is a hidden Mickey pin, 4 of 5 from 2017, I think. But I love these pins together because they're both watermelon, so yay. And watermelon obviously makes me think of summer.
My summer answer.
And sun and all things hot.
Every time I read this question, the thing that got stuck in my head was like, summer belongs to you from Phineas and Ferb.
Really?
Yeah. So my answer for this question is this Beach Club Resort pin, and this pin is so pretty. It's got 2 little flip-flops with Mickeys on the toes, and a starfish, and a sand dollar, and a shells, and seahorse, and it's really cute.
Everything beach-themed.
Every beachy thing with Mickey elements to them. Look, the seahorse's tail is even a little Mickey head. I love it. This was from 2015, and it is just so cute and so summery and beachy, and I love it. Question 12. Show your favorite patriotic pin. I'm guessing this is for 4th of July.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have the perfect pin for this answer. That's what I think. And it's because it's Happy Independence Day 2018. And it's got Sam Eagle on it. You might see my miniature, it's not really that small, ever-growing Muppets collection in this tag. So this is a limited edition of 5,000 from 2018. And it just says Happy Independence Day. And it's him looking very patriotic. And very proud to be American, as Sam always is. So I like this pin a lot. It makes me smile. It's good.
And it's a good size, too.
It's a pretty big one.
The pin that I have selected for this answer is this Hidemiki American flag pin. So this is a pretty simple pin. I think they've released multiple generations of this pin. This one was from 2001, so it's more of an OG style. But it just has the American flag with the stars and the stripes. And I love how clean of a design this is. It's just Mickey's head and the American flag. So that's my pin for this answer. Question 13. The spooks come out at night. What is your favorite Halloween pin? So this one, I actually struggled a little bit to find a pin because neither of us collect Halloween pins, but I actually had this one on my trader board, so I'm gonna use it.
If anyone wants to trade for it, hit her up. She's trading it.
Well, it's cute. It's really cute. And it is this Mickey Sheet Ghost pin. So this was an open edition pin from 2013, and I love it. It's just super cute. Very cutesy ghost,
yeah,
which I love, and he looks like he's going to go trick-or-treating dressed as a ghost. So this is my Halloween pin.
My answer for this question is this cute, also Mickey Halloween pin. The reason I love this so much, it's all purple, and I love it.
Yeah, and it's a kind of unique
it's a very unique
color
pin.
Combination.
So it is Mickey, I guess he's dressed up almost as a vampire, but he doesn't have, vampire teeth. So maybe he's just, Count Halloween. I don't know. But he's got, a little pumpkin bow tie and his trick-or-treating Mickey pumpkin.
That's also his face.
Barrel. That's really cute. And his ears and the moon behind him form Jack Skellington's face. Which is really cool.
There's so much going on.
And I love it. This is from 2008. I think it's just an open edition pin. But it's really cool. I love all of the elements going on here. Question 14. Share your favorite attraction pin. So, you remember when I said the Muppets were going to be a big thing? Here they are again. This is a Disney, piece of Walt Disney World history pin. Which contains a piece of the Muppet Vision 3D attraction balloon basket. That's a lot of words on the back of this pin. So this is a really cute one for Muppet Vision 3D. This yellow bit is really sparkly, and then there's the film reel and the film clapper board. And Kermit's like, come on in, see our show, and the iconic balloon behind him. And then in this little dome, there's a little piece of the attraction, which is cool. And this is limited edition of 1500, and I really like this pin a lot. So this, I think, is the only piece of history that they've done so far that I, like, really wanted to have. Are they still making those?
Yeah. The one that is on my bucket list to get is the sorcerer hat.
Oh, yeah.
I would love to have a sorcerer hat piece of history, but yeah.
Yeah. I like this one a lot because Muppet Vision is one of my favorite attractions at Hollywood Studios, and I, you know, collect the Muppets now, apparently.
Yeah. My pin for this answer is this one right here. And this is for Soarin'. So this pin was actually released before the redo of Soarin', before Soarin' Around the World was a thing. But I think it still works. It doesn't really say that it was the original. But I like both. I like Soarin' Around the World and California. But it just says Soarin', and then it's Mickey, Goofy, and Donald. And they are sliding across the sky on their hang glider. And this pin was an open edition from 2005. So Soarin' is definitely...
That's like back when the original opened.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was...
Here, anyway.
It was a while ago.
I don't know how long it was in Disneyland, but here.
Yeah, and this is one of my favorite attractions is Soarin'. Question 15. Time to give thanks. Share a Thanksgiving pin or a pin that represents Thanksgiving to you.
So, the Muppets pull through again with these holiday-themed pins. I love it. So this,
oh my gosh.
This one could have worked for my, like, most characters one as well, because there's five Muppets around this table. But it says, Happy Thanksgiving 2018, and there's Gonzo, Animal, Miss Piggy, Kermit, and Fozzie. And they're having Thanksgiving dinner, and there's, like, a cornucopia that's rubberized and raised in the middle. And this one is a limited edition of 4,000. And it's just so cute. They're little family. I love them. And I love this pin a lot. It's so cute and adorable. And it's one of my favorites that I have. Probably in my whole collection, to be honest, maybe.
Yeah. My pin for this answer is this pin from 2000. And it says, Happy Thanksgiving on the bottom. And it is Mickey and Minnie. And they are actually praying over their Thanksgiving feast, which... I love. Again, this is a 2000 pin, so it fits in my older pins collection. I don't really have that many Thanksgiving pins. This one is a limited edition of 7,500. This pin is my Thanksgiving answer.
Question 16. What is your favorite princess pin or a pin with your favorite character on it? This pin is... both one of my favorite princess pins and a pin of my favorite princess. So this is a Belle cameo pin, and I have several in this collection. It was a mystery box, and they're so pretty. They're just so pretty. I love them. So the background is yellow and very sparkly, and then there's a rose at the top of the frame, and it's just a gorgeous pin. And this is from 2016, I think. Yes, 2016. Tiny little numbers.
Yeah. My pin for this answer, this was a really difficult one to choose as well because I collect many different princesses and I have quite a few favorites, and so to pick one was like, what? But I think I'm gonna go with this one. This is a Disney Studio Store Hollywood pin, and this one is Anna, and she's in front of a stained glass window element. But I love this one so much because she is in her coronation dress, and that is my favorite of Anna's outfits. This one is a limited edition of 400, and every time I look at this pin, it makes me smile because I love her expression, and the blue stained glass in the back is absolutely beautiful, so this pin is my favorite. Question 17, share your favorite Christmas pin. For me on this question, I have, a fairly large Christmas and holiday pin collection, but if I'm being honest, I can't really get to a lot of my favorite pins of this collection because they are in shadow boxes that are like mounted for life.
They look really pretty, but you can't get them down.
Yeah, so I might do a collection video on those another time where I actually take the camera setup into the shadow boxes and show you, but today I'm gonna go with this one because I was able to reach it. So So this is the pin I'm going to share with you today, and it is this really cute Santa Claus Mickey pin. So it's a hidden Mickey head, and in the main body of the pin is Santa's suit. And so it's glittery and it's red.
Very sparkly.
And I love this one. It does make me smile every time I see it. And this one is an open edition pin from 2011.
My answer for this question was this Disney's Contemporary Resort pin from 2016. And it's got like gingerbread bow and some peppermint ornaments around it. And when you open it, it's so cute! I love it! So this was the gingerbread display at the Contemporary in 2016. It was a Frozen theme. And so you see Elsa's ice palace made out of gingerbread, and then there's Kristoff and Olaf and Sven in the front. And it's just so cute, and it's sparkly, and oh, I love it so much. So this one was a limited edition of 2000 from 2016, obviously.
I love that one. That was one of the ones I was considering too, but
Question 18. We're almost there. Share a pin that represents a favorite memory from a past Disney trip. For me, I picked this one. That is one of my favorite of my pins, to be honest. I absolutely love it. And it is an Animal Kingdom Lodge. This was an open edition from 2014. And that was actually the year that we got to go for my birthday and stay there. My favorite animal, like I mentioned, are giraffes. I'm kind of obsessed with them. It's fine. So one of the reasons that I picked this pin when we stayed there was because there's a big old giraffe in the middle and I love it. But Animal Kingdom Lodge, genuinely, if it's not my favorite resort, it's definitely near the top of my list. Just walking in makes me happy, and I just love it there.
My pin for this collection is actually very similar to the one that Abby pulled, in that we both chose resort pins. Yeah. But I chose my Polynesian pin. We stayed at the Polynesian in 2016, and it, to this day, is still one of my maybe top two or top three favorite, like, Disney stays, favorite...
It was a good trip.
...trips. It was incredible. We had so much magic on that trip, and we stayed at the Polynesian. And so... Even now, when we go and visit the Polynesian, it's just like...
It's like coming home.
Oh, it's like, welcome home. Yeah.
Which they say when you walk in the door, and I'm like, thank you!
Yeah, thanks. But I would love to go back and stay there again, and it's seriously one of my best trip memories, vacation memories, I guess. So this was an open edition pin from 2013. All right, the last one. Question 19. Share a pin that you feel most represents you. Now, story time. Abby and I, when we were getting ready for this tag, we obviously like weren't together when we were working through these questions and picking our pins. And we both picked the same pin.
Which is one of our newest pin acquisitions, which is kind of funny, too. But
yeah. So we did not discuss with one another which pin we chose to represent us. So here is the mutual Disney Sisters pin.
This represents both of us. That's pretty true, though. It really does represent, I feel, both of us.
Yeah.
So this is a brand new 2019 Epcot International Festival of the Arts pin, and it says "Dance to the Music in Your Heart," and it's got Minnie dancing and Mickey's playing a guitar, and it's very colorful and there's music notes all over it. And this is limited edition of 2000. I guess I do have one with the year on it. Oh, I do. I have a 2019 pin. Woo! Okay. Anyway, pull yourself together, girl. This pin, I feel, really does represent both of us. We're both dancers, we both love music, and I sing, and you sing too when you want to. Just don't sing in front of people very often, but you have a nice voice.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, yeah, and I love the marbled element of it. I love
the color scheme. It's like very us too. Like, it's very tealy and blues and greens.
Yeah. Music and dance and really the arts in general are a very big part of our lives.
Yeah.
And so this pin just kind of sums it all up.
Mm-hmm.
All right, guys. So that was our pin tag for
2019.
Yeah. So because we are so late to the game on this video, we are not going to be tagging anyone specifically, but we want to tag you. So if you would like to do this tag or you have pins, we would love to see them. So we will leave all of the questions linked in the description box, as well as all of the wonderful people who have done this tag and tagged us, and the creators, Nina and Alicia.
If you want to use this list as like a prompt list for Instagram, tag us in your post. We want to see your pins.
That is all we have for you today. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing down below for more Disney magic.
And we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Hey. It works well in one way. Okay. We'll just go with that. If the whole video is a little crooked, we apologize. We'll just go like this.
What?
This tag was created by Nina from
West Wing with Disney.
I can't even get this out of the thing. Ugh.
So question seven.
Question seven. How am I supposed to concentrate with this?
I didn't pull one for this. Ooh.
You're the Christmas collection queen.
I gotta go do that. I know, I couldn't decide, so I just figured out.